I am the poet of Harlem. I'm on Canal Street in Manhattan. The direction this camera is pointing is west. I took the one train to Canal Street from that direction. And I walked down here to Canal Street and Church. That way on the other side of those buildings, the streets over there, that's Soho. Muhammad Ali had a company over there. Matter of fact, I can cover a little history right here since I'm down here. I came down here for one of the sites of Frederick Douglass's freedom. A gentleman, Caucasian brother, in the recreation center told me where this site is located many years ago. And by accident, okay, gets a little nicer up there. I think they're working on gentrifying this area, but Muhammad Ali's documentary was filmed on Wooster Street by Directors International. The name of the documentary is Muhammad Ali, The Whole Story, most of which was sold to Japan. But anyway, that documentary was created that direction, the headquarters for it. Okay, there's Wooster Street. This is Canal. I came from this way on the one train. Okay. Up there is Varick and Canal. Okay. Going this way, you get into Chinatown. Keep going this direction, you'll get into Chinatown. You make a right, you run into all of the court buildings. That's on Center Street. Okay, what you want to know about going to the Frederick Douglass Freedom Site, or where his house was, the house that helped Frederick Douglass, is that just make a right. If you're coming from the one train, the E or the A, just make a right when you get to the post office. The post office will be on Canal and Church. Okay, post office is on Canal and Church. I remember seeing this post office in the 90s. Okay. This is the United States Post Office on Canal and Church. These videos are helpful because some of our people were not able to read because of a language barrier or a lack of schooling or training. We're still with them. They can still travel with what I'm doing. All praise is due to Allah. Okay, this is Canal Street going west towards the Holland Tunnel. This is Canal Street going east towards Chinatown, the court buildings, I believe the Manhattan Bridge. Okay. We go to the Frederick Douglass House. Just remember, let me see, to make a right towards, you're coming from the east, make a left at Church Street. Canal and Church. Okay. That's where you're gonna turn. You go this way on Church Street. Remember, you're passing the United States Post Office. Okay. I'm gonna walk over here. Interesting family name. Henry Morgenthau Jr., Secretary of Treasury. Very interesting. He might be related to the district attorney, Morgenthau. The district attorney Morgenthau lived to be in his 90s. And he was walking around, still walking around. He might have retired in his 90s also. But anyway, I'm walking on the side of the post office because this is the side of the least opposition. Okay, you'll see the mailman right here, working for his country. People never looked at that way. People at the post office are working for their country. You attack one of them, you assault one of them, you rob one of them, you'll find yourself in federal prison. In federal prison, they probably could send you anywhere. America owns property, including in the South Pacific. But anyway, this is where we're going. That red building across the street, that's the site. The gentleman, very nice guy. He told me, he knows the type of person I am. Matter of fact, all of the old timers, all of the people at Recreation Center pretty much know my appreciation of history and social justice, social change. Some even say a revolution. But anyway, we're here at Church Street. Okay. And the corner here is L'Esplanade. Okay. So remember, the Frederick Douglass House is on Church Street in L'Esplanade. Look up there, you can see the new World Trade Center. World Trade Center 1. Those who've been to Atlanta will say it's reminiscent of the Peachtree Hotel. There's a hotel in Atlanta that make you think about it. Okay, this is the building. This is the site where the Frederick Douglass, this landmark is. I'm gonna learn a little about this. Let me see. Okay, here we are. Underground Railroad Station, 36 L'Esplanade. On September 3rd, 1838, human rights activist Frederick Douglass escaped slavery in Maryland by disguising himself as a sailor and traveling north by carriage, train, and boat. A few days later, he arrived at 36 L'Esplanade Street, then a small brick building and a station of the Underground Railroad, a network of secret conductors and safe houses for fugitive slaves. Here, African-American abolitionist David Ruggles kept a reading room and operated a printing press where he published anti-slavery material, including Mirror of Liberty, headquarters of the New York Vigilance Committee, one of the nation's most active anti-slavery campaigns, which aided more than 1,000 freedom-seeking men, women, and children. Yes, children want freedom too. I don't know if their parents care about it, but children want freedom too for different things. Good things, support them. They want freedom to do good things, support them. But this is the site that I was given. And remember, it's across the street, diagonally from the United States Post Office. United States Post Office is at Church and Canal. You walk south this way to L'Esplanade, and you come across the street to this building. You follow family history, pay attention to the elders, you learn a little bit more about your family, most cases in America. All right, this is 36 L'Esplanade. When I came this area many times to look, many years ago, to look at this Frederick Douglass site, I was not aware of my family connection to this building. Once my sister, her husband and children, and another sister from Washington and her children were here in New York City, we walked on Canal Street in this direction. We walked on Canal Street in this direction. What we did not know, only way I found out, it was I did research on a gentleman named Jack Whitten. Jack Whitten, according to family records, family documentation, Jack Whitten would be my uncle, if you will. Jack Whitten had a show. He's an artist, world famous artist. Keep in mind, just because you don't know the artist, it doesn't mean they're not world famous or the right people know them. Okay, the right people knew Jack Whitten. May he rest in peace. He passed away. Matter of fact, President Obama gave him a Medal of the Arts, which Jack Whitten referred to as a Medal of Honor. But Jack Whitten was also an actor. There's a gentleman named Maurizio Catalan. Doesn't have a website. Jack Whitten didn't have a website. And that building, Jack Whitten lived there, is 36 Lisbonard. The coffee house is 319 Church Street. 319 makes me think of March 19th. My mother would know a little something about March 19th. But the address on to that coffee house on the Church Street side is 319. Jack Whitten's place, he owned that entire building, Jack Whitten. He lived there. That was his entire building. Jack Whitten lived in this area. It's called Tribeca. You may hear of it or heard of this area in the Jay-Z song, New York or Empire State of Mind or whatever. But Jay-Z mentions Tribeca. It's Robbie De Niro is not too, his restaurant is not too far from here. But let me get over here. His truck is blocking me. That happens when you're trying to accomplish something. Obstacles get in your way, but we can walk around it. Thank God we can walk around things. Appreciate that I can walk. Okay. That's the building from the Church Street side. But Jack Whitten, he had an exhibit at the Metropolitan Museum of Art. And it was very impressive. He was a sculptor and a painter. He attended the Cooper Union, 1960. Before that, he was a student at Tuskegee in Alabama for a short while. And at Tuskegee, one of the jobs he had working was to clean the laboratory of Dr. George Washington Carver, the great agricultural scientist. I saw Dr. Carver's building when I was visiting Tuskegee from the outside and very impressed. I went by Booker T. Washington's house, walked up the steps on the porch. Very inspiring. But Jack Whitten, he lived here during his sojourn in New York. When he passed away, he had a home in Queens. I think it was Woodside, Queens. But anyway, Jack Whitten, as I said, is a world-class artist. Just because you don't know them does not mean progress is not being made in their sphere of activity. Maurizio Catalan, a friend of mine, he's a very nice guy. Maurizio Catalan does not have a website. Alex Dijon, the photographer who passed away, may he rest in peace, he doesn't have a website. I remember I asked Alex Dijon, I believe his son, Alex Dijon, was the Secretary of Treasury or something like that. He worked for the Democratic Party. I believe as their treasurer for the Democratic Party. His name is also Dijon. Okay, I'm just saying this to let you know, just because you don't know who they are, does not mean people made accomplishments. That people have accomplishments. That people made giant steps on this planet. So we're gonna come over here. This is the Tribeca Soho. Nice hotel, top hotel. Okay, the Tribeca Grand, I'm sorry. Tribeca Grand, Soho is behind me, across canal. As you see, the name of this street is Walker Street. That's one of those ironies. That's my grandfather's family. My grandfather's last name, Walker. Okay, getting back down the street is where the building owned by Jack Whitten. Jack Whitten lived in this neighborhood for such a long time. He enjoyed this neighborhood. It wasn't gentrified like it is now, but it was nice. He saw the building. No, let me say it right. He saw the hole in the ground. He saw them digging for the World Trade Center, the original one. He saw them building the World Trade Center. And because he lived in Tribeca, yes, he saw the destruction happening at the World Trade Center that we know, the Twin Towers, the one that was here in our time. Before that area, or that era, there was no World Trade Center. It was a community that had Syrian people, Syrians. Their history is a little mixed, but I don't want to get into it. They speak Arabic. Syrians speak Arabic. But that doesn't mean that they are Arab. Their ancestry may go back to somewhere else. As Muhammad Assad wrote in his book, Road to Mecca, he had mentioned what the Zionists at that time were referring to Palestinians as. And he said, who you are calling Arabs are nothing but Arabized Canaanites who were there before the Kingdom of Judea, during the Kingdom of Judea, and after the Kingdom of Judea. Because someone speaks a language, it does not mean that they belong where you see them or they are how you see them now. Same as in America, same as me. I don't know how I would have been many years ago. I don't know. But how you see us in certain areas as humans, if we are not indigenous, have strong roots in that area, more than likely we have another history that has not been told. Okay, I just wanted to say that. We have history that may have not been told or explained. At the end of the day, everyone is from the human race, the human family. That's why you see all kinds of people walking by me now. But anyway, Jack Whitten's brother was also an artist, a skilled designer, world-class, top-notch, top-flight, high as you can go. His name was Bill Whitten. Bill Whitten also passed. May both of them rest in peace. They were brothers. Jack Whitten received the Medal of the Arts from President Obama in 2016. Bill Whitten was the designer of Michael Jackson. When you look at Michael Jackson holding those Grammys that he got, he and Quincy Jones picked up because of the Thriller, that spectacular, amazing Thriller album, that jacket, that white glove, the high water pants, white socks, the loafers or whatever. That style, that image was given to Michael Jackson by Jack Whitten's brother, Bill Whitten. And one of Bill Whitten's people are still alive. I mean, the workers, they're still alive. And they call him, one of his students called him the immensely talented Bill Whitten. Bill Whitten was a designer for rock stars, Neil Sedaka, the Rolling Stones, Elton John. He was a designer for those people, but you don't know him. He doesn't have a website. I only saw stories about him recently, within the past few years ago, maybe three, you know. But his workers, they are still alive and they can tell you. They are out in Los Angeles. They could tell you about Bill Whitten. But Bill Whitten is the brother of Jack Whitten. Bill Whitten, the designer, Michael Jackson designer. I knew of my family connection to Bill Whitten. I ran across Randy Jackson in Los and Beverly Hills. I never thought to bring it up that Bill Whitten, I'm connected to him. Your brother's designer, Michael Jackson designer, I'm connected to him. I talked for a half hour, interviewed for a half hour. Mr. Joe Jackson, nice gentleman, righteous gentleman. I didn't think to bring up Bill Whitten's name. I ran across Jermaine Jackson. I didn't think to bring up Bill Whitten's name. I knew a gentleman named Majestic. He worked for Muhammad Ali and Michael Jackson and the Jackson family, Mr. Jackson, Mrs. Jackson, very nice guy. May he rest in peace. Majestic the Magnificent was a magician, and he was a confidant for Muhammad Ali, mostly Michael Jackson, also Jackson family. I didn't think to tell Majestic about my connection to Bill Whitten. I don't sing songs. I don't write songs. I don't dance. I don't play instruments. But my mother would know about this. On Jack Whitten, the address on Jack Whitten's building on the Church Street side is 319, going south in the direction of the World Trade Center. That next block is Walker Street. And this is across from the post office, Canal Street. But this building is the home of Bill Whitten. When he owned the building, he sold the building. And I was told about this building many years ago as being the site of the Underground Railroad for Frederick Douglass. And if you ever come to New York and you take the train, the 2 or the 3 train, the A train, the C train, to Chambers Street and walk west, as if you're walking towards the water, or walking towards the, walking towards the water, on Chambers Street, there is a highway, a very large highway, I believe they call it the West Side Highway. You go across the West Side Highway to Stuyvesant High School, and go around the back, go to the rear of the Stuyvesant High School. There is a marker there for, there's a marker also for Frederick Douglass. That's another site. And in that area is a memorial for the Irish who perished in, who suffered. All of them didn't die. Some died, but some suffered greatly because of what's called the potato famine. J.A. Rogers wrote that off as what it was, historian J.A. Rogers. An Irish gentleman I know from Staten Island, he called it what it was. He called it genocide. He said the potato famine, the potato crop failed, that crop failed. But there were vegetables still grown in Ireland. And he said what historian J.A. Rogers said. Yes, yes, that was genocide. Vegetables were grown in Ireland, but the Irish could not afford to buy their, it was their vegetables, they grew it. They could not afford to buy them. They were very expensive. And those vegetables were shipped off to England, Britain, it was shipped to them. The Irish didn't get to eat the food that they grew. They did not get to benefit from what their own hands had done. So the potato famine is one thing, or the failure of that as a crop. The rest of it is genocide. The people did not have access to their own food. They grew on their own land. The food was grown in Ireland, The food was grown in Ireland by the Irish, and it was shipped to Britain. If the Irish wanted to buy that food, the prices was too high. They couldn't afford that. So that's how a lot of people suffered. This World Trade Center, let me get a good shot of that World Trade Center. Where this World Trade Center is, this is building one. If you go to the World Trade Center, go on the other side of the highway to the building is called the World Financial Center. Near the World Financial Center, near that park, near Rockefeller Park, you will see a building made of stone. Nice building, looks like a memorial, but it is a memorial. It's like a work of art. It's made of stone. And those stones, and I believe the soil itself comes from Ireland. And that is the memorial for the people who perished in Ireland during a genocidal moment that some people call a famine, but potato famine. Even though there were vegetables, there were crops that the Irish could have benefited from. That's a historian J.A. Rogers' work. You talk to the Irish who know their history, they'll tell you the same thing. But anyway, the memorial for the Irish is near one World Trade Center. Go on the other side of the highway. Be careful crossing, because that's quite a street to cross. Go around the World Financial Center, go through it. Go to the other side. There's a beautiful park there, beautiful plaza. Go over to the grass and where the basketball courts are located, and the beautiful pond. In front of that, you will see the memorial for the Irish. Okay. So I gave you that history. And Frederick Douglass, I read, he visited Ireland and visited some of the leaders of that time in Ireland. So this is a site for Frederick Douglass at Church and Lispinard. And this building is a building that was owned by the great artist from Bessemer, Alabama, Jack Whitten. He received the Medal of the Arts from President Obama in 2016. And his brother is Bill Whitten, the designer for Michael Jackson. Bill Whitten was going to move to New York and build a studio or build a store over on the other side of that area where those buildings are. That's Soho. He was gonna build a store on that side, in that direction, but not directly in front of us. Probably near the Broadway, where we are now is Church Street. But Soho and Broadway, that's where the main places are. Or Prince Street. Prince Street has the first Apple store that we used in New York. It was an old post office that was converted to an Apple store. And that's in Soho, Prince, near the Prince Street subway station. But I wanted to give this history, this information about Frederick Douglass. A gentleman told me about this building many years ago. And reading the book written by Jack Whitten, this is how I know this. The name of the book Jack Whitten wrote, it's a collection of his diary or his memoirs or his notes from 1960s, early 1960s to this new millennium. And his name is Notes from the Woodshed. Jack Whitten, Notes from the Woodshed. His family is still alive. Ironically, he has a child named Kata. That's the last name I use, Kata, K-E-I-T-A. Comes from Mali, from the family of Mansa Musa. Okay, here we are. Underground Railroad Station.